Hey guys, so it's Jaden from Laser Gaming. We're back with another Battlefield 1 video, and I'm going to be telling you how to unlock the Mosin in Battlefield 1 in the Name of the Tsar DLC. Now, before I get into this video, just like to say that I am doing a giveaway of the In the Name of the Tsar DLC, so don't forget to subscribe down below, leave a comment on one of these videos, and go check out my video talking about it specifically, and it'll have all the details on how to enter the giveaway for this DLC, because in order to unlock this weapon, you do need to own the DLC. So if you don't own the DLC, I definitely recommend entering the giveaway, just so you can have a chance to get it for free. But in order to unlock the two different versions of this weapon, we're going to start off with the infantry version, and you need two headshots in one round with the SMLE infantry. This is not too hard. The only hard part about this is you're trying to get a headshot with a weapon that does not have a scope, so you're going to end up having to either just eyeball it, which I kind of did in the clips that you'll see. I kind of just hit the enemies at long range by having pretty precise aim. For those of you who aren't snipers too often, I'd recommend just at least trying to sneak up on an enemy and hitting them in the head from the back or something when they're not moving. Now next, this is also easy. Compared to the marksman version, the infantry version is much easier. So the other things, you only need 20 kills with the Mars Automatic, which is already one of the best pistols in the game. So not too hard on the infantry, and once you complete both of those, you should unlock it. Now, next we're going to be looking at the Mosin Nagant marksman, where you need 50 kills with the Gewehr 98 marksman, and 15 kills with the Tripwire Bomb HE. Now, the 50 kills with the Gewehr 98 marksman can be done over any period of games. You can do it over 50 games, or if you're having a really good game, you can do it in just one game. But that is not dependent on games like the first assignment in the Mosin Nagant, where you need to get two headshots in one round. Now, next, you need 15 kills with the Tripwire Bomb HE. So when you're trying this, make sure you're running the HE. This one is actually much harder, and again, you can complete it over a number of games, but getting 15 kills with the Tripwire is going to be quite hard. So I don't know what I'd do. I'd recommend playing on very infantry focused maps, and it should be a bit easier to get, but it still is going to be quite hard considering how weak the Tripwire HE bomb is. Now, once you complete both of these, you will get access to the Mosin Nagant Infantry and the Mosin Nagant Marksman. The sweet spot for the Mosin Nagant is around 75 meters to 125 meters, making it more of a longer range sniper rifle, and it still does have a relatively fast fire rate of 55 rounds per minute. It's a super interesting sniper rifle, it looks super awesome, and definitely fits the theme of the Russian DLC. If you guys enjoyed the video, don't forget to drop a like down below, subscribe if you are new here for everything in the Battlefield universe. But that's what it is to be, guys. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.